There's five wide receivers. I'm looking to start heading into week 13. The first guy's Allen Robinson of the Chicago Bears. And Robinson, his outlook is looking better now for this fantasy season with Mitchell Trubisky in there at quarterback. We saw Robinson have a great ball game versus the Green Bay Packers with 8 catches, 74 yards, and 2 touchdowns on 13 targets. I know that second touchdown was in garbage time, but Robinson, he dropped one early in the ball game. So Robinson, he's going to be good the rest of the way if Trubisky starts, because he could get the ball down the field at least. And now here in week 13, he's got a great matchup versus the Detroit Lions, so I think he could have a good game. Lions give up the 9th most fantasy points to wide receivers, and in week 1, we're going all the way back versus Detroit. When Trubisky was in there, he had 5 catches for 74 yards on 9 targets. I could see a similar type of ball game, but also a touchdown added in there. So go start Allen Robinson. The second guy's Corey Davis of the Tennessee Titans. And Davis, this guy's finally living up to expectations here for the Tennessee Titans after he was a high draft pick a few seasons ago. And he's got double-digit fantasy points now, is Davis, in 5 out of his last 6 ball games since he came back in week 7. And now here versus Cleveland, gives up the 12th most fantasy points to wide receivers. I could see Davis having another big ball game in this one and possibly finding the end zone. The last few ball games, Davis, he's got at least 70 yards. I could see 70 yards and a touchdown in this one, because the attention, it's not rolled to him. He's got single coverage each and every time. Teams got to worry about Derrick Henry loading the box, and then AJ Brown on the outside, who's an absolute monster this year. So Davis, I like the outlook and I like the game he's gonna have this week. The third guy is Devontae Parker of the Miami Dolphins. When Ryan Fitzpatrick's in the game, Devontae Parker, he does work, and last week we saw a huge game out of him versus a weak Jet defense with 8 catches, 119 yards on 14 targets. So that's good target work, that's good catches, and that's a lot of yards. And with Tua in there, we've seen him struggle with mediocre to poor games at best. And this week versus Cincinnati, if as long as Fitzpatrick's in there, I like Parker again, and I could see him reach that 100-yard barrier once again in this ball game. Cincinnati gives up the 13th most fantasy points to wide receivers, and Parker, he's a good receiver. This is why they paid him, but he needs a quarterback like Fitzpatrick that could stretch the field for him. Because if you don't have a quarterback in there, and Tua's in there, it's a lot of short routes, and he don't really stretch the field. So he's the third guy. The fourth guy's Brandon Cooks of the Houston Texans. He's the number one man over there now in Houston after Will Fuller got suspended for the rest of the season, testing positive for PED use. And Cooks, he's been pretty good since Bill O'Brien got fired in week 4. Cooks got double-digit fantasy games in all his ball games in PPR leagues besides week 10. And this week, it's a tough matchup versus Indy that gives up the 6th least amount of fantasy points to wide receivers. But he's the number one dog there. He's got a top 5 quarterback in Deshaun Watson there. And he's a guy I'm going to have confidence in, because Cooks, he could still make moves. He could still get open. And if this game they're trailing early and often, you know Watson's going to have to throw and try to find them there. Plus, their receiving corps, they're banged up. Randall Cobb on IR, Fuller suspended, like I said. And Kenny Stills, we don't know if he's going to play. So it's really Cooks and Cootie and a bunch of no-names now over there in Houston. So I like Cooks as the fourth starter. And the fifth and final guy is Deebo Samuel of the San Francisco 49ers. Samuel, he came back with a huge ball game last week in a shocking victory over the Los Angeles Rams. And Samuel, they use him everywhere on the field. He makes a lot of big plays. And he had an awesome ball game with 24 fantasy points, 11 catches, 133 yards on 13 targets. This week he's got Buffalo, which this ball game I could see being a mini shootout or them even trailing early and having to throw it all over. So last week, to put up those numbers with Jalen Ramsey shadowing him most of the ball game's impressive. Now he's got Buffalo this week, and I could see a good game out of him, 80 or 90 yards and possibly finding the end zone. And he's their gadget guy over there. And Brandon Ayuk, he's coming back as well. So maybe he could open up the field a little bit as well for Deebo and the San Francisco 49ers. So that's 5 wide receivers I'm looking to start here heading into week 13.